Imagine you're at the edge of a canyon, peering down at the layers of stone beneath your feet. Or maybe you've climbed all the way to the top of a mountain with rocky peaks stretching out in every direction. These massive features of our planet may seem eternal and unchanging, but every single rock is somewhere in the middle of an extraordinary transformation. In fact, the boulders on that mountain peak could one day become the pebbles at the bottom of the canyon. Today, we'll take a closer look at this process as we join some rocks on their never-ending journey. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to describe how rocks change during the rock cycle and identify the processes that make up the rock cycle. Let's get started! In our last lesson, we learned about the three different types of rocks. Igneous rocks, which are formed when molten rock cools and hardens. Metamorphic rocks, which are formed when rocks are changed by heat and pressure. And sedimentary rocks, which are formed when sediment is compressed into rocks. These rocks are all formed when something changes, whether that's magma cooling down or an existing rock transforming. So, what causes these changes, and how do they impact each kind of rock? This is where the rock cycle comes in. The rock cycle is the interconnected system of processes that causes rocks to change over time. Eventually, the processes in the rock cycle can cause one rock to change into each different type. But how does this really happen? Let's start with hot, molten rocks to find out. When molten rocks cool, they harden and solidify. This forms igneous rocks. But the rock cycle is just getting started. We already know how both metamorphic and sedimentary rocks form. What do you think would need to happen to an igneous rock for it to change into one of these other kinds? Pause the video here and record your thinking in your guided notes. There are a few different processes that can change igneous rocks. Over many, many years, forces like wind and water might break the igneous rock down into tiny pieces. This process is a part of the rock cycle called weathering and erosion. When rocks are weathered and eroded, they become sediments. And over time, a process called compaction can tightly squeeze these sediments together, while another process called cementation can cause them to stick together. Together, compaction and cementation form sedimentary rocks from sediments. Processes like cementation, compaction, weathering, and erosion cause the rocks that make up Earth's surface to constantly shift. Over time, these rocks can end up buried in the middle of mountains or even miles underground. This puts them under huge amounts of heat and pressure, and eventually, all the heat and pressure starts to change these rocks through a process called metamorphism. Sound familiar? This heat and pressure causes igneous and sedimentary rocks to transform into metamorphic rocks. If the rocks get hot enough, they might even melt and eventually harden back into, you guessed it, igneous rocks. See why it's called the rock cycle? These changes can happen over and over again. But the rock cycle doesn't just take rocks from igneous to sedimentary to metamorphic over and over again. These processes can change rocks in just about any order. Any kind of rock can be broken down into sediments by weathering and erosion. Any kind of rock can melt into molten rock and harden into an igneous rock. And any kind of rock can undergo metamorphism and become a metamorphic rock. That means rocks can even repeatedly change into the same kind of rock that they already are. For example, an igneous rock might heat up enough that it melts back into magma again, right away, then cools and solidifies again. Or weathering and erosion might break a sedimentary rock back down into sediment. Then compaction and cementation might put it back together again. Even a metamorphic rock can undergo metamorphism and change into a different kind of metamorphic rock. In fact, a single rock might be changed by all of these processes over time. For example, granite is a type of igneous rock. When it is weathered and eroded into sediment, then compacted and cemented back together, it becomes sandstone. Then, if sandstone is changed over time by heat and pressure, it becomes gneiss. These rocks are all made of the same minerals, just at different points in the rock cycle. Now, let's think back to the deep canyon and rocky mountain peaks from the beginning of our journey today. Those layered canyon walls might have been made of sandstone, while the mountain peaks were made of gneiss and granite. Although these features of our planet's surface might seem huge and unchanging, they're all just snapshots of different stages in the never-ending rock cycle. The rock cycle is just one piece of the interconnected processes that are constantly reshaping our planet's surface. And every rock around us is a reminder that our planet is constantly changing. The rocks at the bottom of a canyon today could become the peak of a mountain in the future. But in the meantime, let's recap what we learned today. Now you know that the rock cycle is the interconnected system of processes that causes rocks to change over time, and that those processes include melting, cooling, weathering, erosion, compaction, cementation, and metamorphism. Be sure to check out the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to learn even more about how the rock cycle shapes our planet. And always remember, in earth science, as in life, you rock! See you next time!